to which I'm totally opposed. I'm generally opposed wisdom. I think wisdom is the most disgusting thing you can imagine. Wisdom is the most conformist thing you can imagine. Wisdom is this, you know, whatever you do, a wise man will come and justify it, you know. Like, you do something risky and you succeed. There will be a wise man who will come and say something like, I don't know, we in Slovene, we have a proverb, maybe you have a similar one, only those who risk profit, and so on and so on. Let's say you do the same thing but fail. A wise man will come and he will say something like, in Slovene we had a vulgar saying, which says, you cannot urinate against the wind or something like that. You know, this is wisdom. Whatever you do, a wise guy will come and wisdom, you know,
But it's so interesting that a philosopher should be against wisdom.
We all are. I mean, your Kierkegaard knew this. Kierkegaard was anti-wise man par excellence. Wisdom is pagan. Not going to my Stalinist stuff. But what I wanted, once I made a mental experiment, if you don't believe me. I will say, I don't know how to say it, I'm too ironic with all this pathos, you know. Why are we running after this miserable earthly pleasures? Think about eternity. The only satisfaction is eternity. If I were to say it with proper pathos, it would sound a deep thing to say.
Let's say
the opposite. Why run after the specter of eternity? Carpe diem, grasp what you have here. It sounds wise. Now I will say the third option. Why be caught in a contrast between eternity and temporary existence? The true wisdom is to see eternity in fleeting temporary pleasures. It is wise. Then I say the fourth variation. We are forever condemned between the two. A wise man accepts this. You know, whatever I say, that's my point. You can sell it as a wisdom. This is a wisdom.